Hello everyone, I'm Sushmita Sarkar from RV College of Engineering. I welcome all of you for lecture 11 in the course Power System Analysis 2, Module 1. So in this particular lecture, we will see the Gauss-Seidel method for LFA considering both PV and PQ buses. So I hope all of you remember the last lectures where we have understood the load flow analysis by using Gauss-Seidel method only for PQ buses. So in today's lecture, we'll see what happens when we also have PV buses into the system. So let us go through the algorithm. Okay, how does the algorithm changes when PV buses are considered? So the first few steps are same. Step number one, read the bus data and line data. Step number two, I hope all of you remember, what is step number two, guys? Yes, we have to form an Y bus. Fine, so the step number two says, after reading the bus data and line data, form the Y bus, assume a flat voltage profile of 1 plus of J0 for all the PQ buses, and assume a suitable value for your convergence. Fine, step number three, now you have to set the iteration count, K is equal to 1. Then we have step number four, set bus count, P is equal to 1. Fine, so before going to the step number five, let us know what are the quantities available for PV bus. We know the quantities available for PV buses, the real power and the magnitude of voltage. So if the real power and magnitude of voltage are there, that and also one more quantity will be specified, that is the Q limits. Fine, so the minimum value of reactive power and the maximum value of the reactive power will be present. It will be specified. So we need to find out what is the actual value of the reactive power at that particular bus and whether it is within the limit or not. If the Q limits of that particular PV bus is within the limit, then the bus will be treated as PV bus. And if it violates the limit, we will see in the algorithm what will happen. It will be treated as a PQ bus. Fine. So let us see what happens. So check, the very next thing is you are setting an iteration count. After that, inside that particular loop, you're setting the bus count. So if your first bus is a slack bus, then go to next step. Since you check for slack bus, if it is not a slack bus, then go to next step. Since voltage as slack bus is fixed both in magnitude and phase, and it does not vary during the iterative procedure. So go to step number 11 if it is a slack bus. So you need to go to step number 11. So step number 11 will be definitely what? Increase the bus count. Step number 11 should be increase the bus count, which will be P equal to P plus of 1. Fine. Now, if it is not a slack bus, then please go to the next step. What is the next step says? Check for generator bus. Fine. So if it is a generator bus, go to the next step or else go to step number 9. Fine. So now what is there in the, if it is a generator bus, replace the value of magnitude of PV bus in that iteration by the specified value and phase of VP of K same as the that iteration. Calculate QP of K. Fine. So if it is a PV bus, you supposed to follow this. You cannot take a flat voltage profile of PV bus voltage because your voltage has already been specified. You know, for a PV bus, P and B values are specified. So you cannot take a flat voltage profile for that particular bus. Fine. So you supposed to consider that particular bus voltage as VP specified only. Fine. So the very first thing, once you come to know it is a PV bus, calculate the reactive power at that particular bus. And you need to check the limits, whether it is satisfying or not. Fine. So let us see how to find that reactive power. What is the formula for that reactive power? For that, we are going to take a complex power conjugate, which says V conjugate I for the pth bus. Fine. So I can write this also as a real power minus the reactive power. So I am putting as IP value, which we have done in our very first or second lessons or lectures, where we have seen VP of conjugate is your sigma Q is equal to 1 YPQ VQ. So sigma Q is equal to 1 to N YPQ VQ is a value of your IP. Okay. So now what is the next thing? So you, after that, you are going to get the value of QP from here. So basically, this is the equation of your complex power. So you solve this equation, and in this equation, the negative of the imaginary part will be the reactive power answer. Fine. I repeat, this particular value, when you substitute, when you solve this particular formula for complex power, your answer will be in the rectangular form, where you will be getting a real power as well as the imaginary power. So the negative of that imaginary power will give you the value of QP. Fine, so that's why we write negative of imaginary. The reason of writing negative is in your, this equation, your reactive power is in terms of negative. So that negative we transform over here as the imaginary part of this particular expression. Fine, so if I open this bracket, if I open this summation sign and split it into the updated values, because it is not necessary that only your second bus has to be PV bus, fine. Your PV bus can be any one of the buses out of n number of buses, fine. So for that calculation of that particular, for that particular iteration, you should take the updated values of the voltages before that particular bus, fine. So that is the reason how you're splitting up your summation. You are splitting up your summation for the values which are already updated for that particular iteration, and which is the previous iteration values you are taking it up. Okay, so we are basically splitting it up with the updated values and with the previous iteration values. So definitely you know that. So the updated values will be before the pth bus, because you are calculating the reactive power for the pth bus. So before this bus, the voltages are already updated. That's why you write Q is equal to 1 to P minus 1. And after this bus, the voltages need to be calculated. That's why your sigma should starts from, yeah, we also need to, it's not P plus 1, because you are not calculating voltage over here. You're calculating the reactive power. So you're reacting at this particular voltage is still, you are not, it has not been calculated. So you put it as Q is equal to P to N. Okay, very important. It's not Q is equal to P plus 1. It is Q is equal to P to 1, N, YPQ, VQ, K minus of 1. Okay. So with the help of this, please don't forget this particular equation, because this is very important for Gauss Seidel method, where PV buses are also considered. Fine, so now what will I do? I'm going to check this QP. We usually call it as a QP calculated value. This is a formula for calculated reactive power. Fine, now this QP calculated value, whether it is lying within the limit or not. So it will be the limit of the Q value will be specified, the minimum or maximum. So if this value is satisfying the limit, then this bus will be considered as a PV bus. Okay, so this particular bus is going to be treated as PV bus, and for that particular bus, reactive power will be taken as the calculated value. For that particular bus, the reactive power will be taken as the calculated value. Fine. So in that case, what will happen? Okay, before going to that, let us see if what happens if the QP cal violates the limit. So if the QP cal violates the limit, it will be violating either the lower limit or the upper limit. So if it violates the lower limit, then you have to set the QP is equal to QP mean. Otherwise, it has to be QP max, because it can violate either the lower or higher limit. So if it has violated the lower limit, then your QP, the reactive power at that particular bus, will be set to a QP mean. Otherwise, it will be set to a QP max. Fine. So you can check that. So it will be set to QP mean. If it is, obviously, if it is not less than that, then it will be greater than QP max. So you are setting to the QP max. If it is within the limit, then it will be equal to QP cal. Fine. So now, since the bus is treated as a load bus, so if it is violating the limit, then it will automatically become a PQ bus for that particular iteration. Every iteration, you need to check this Q value. If for that particular iteration, if it violates the limit, then it will be treated as a load bus only for that particular iteration. Fine. So since the bus is treated as a load bus, take the actual VP of K for the kth iteration. Okay, so you need not replace by BP specified. So once it has violated the limit, it is going to be treated as PQ bus. So how you treat the other PQ bus, same way you have to treat this, which means the voltage at this particular bus will now be considered as flat voltage profile. You cannot take the value of VP specified once it violates the limit. It has to be treated just like as your any PQ buses. Fine. So I hope it is clear for everybody. Now for PV bus. Now if the bus is a PV bus, it is within the limit and it is going to be treated as PV bus, then your magnitude of the that particular bus voltage will be equal to VP specified. But what you need to find out? You need to find out the angle. So to find out that angle, you need to use the Gauss-Seidel equation for load flow. And with the help of that particular equation, we usually say the Gauss-Seidel equation as VP of K, but in this particular case, we'll be calling as VP temporary of K, okay? Why? Because I don't want the magnitude of the voltage, because the magnitude of voltage is already specified, fine? So I only required the delta value from it. So I will be calculating just to get the value of the phase of the voltage, okay? So I will be calculating VP K temporary. So you will be using the same Gauss-Seidel equation. And with that, you will be getting an answer of VP temporary. When you solve this, you will be getting one magnitude and one angle. So in this, what happened? I don't want this magnitude because my bus is going to be treated as PV bus since it has not violated the Q limits. Fine. So I will be replacing this VP K temporary to a VP specified. Fine. So now we are going to consider the voltage at this particular bus is going to be the specified voltage, okay, which is given in the problem, and this delta PK temporary. So basically you have solved this only to get the value of delta. So you are going to take this delta value, and this is already specified in this particular bus, PV bus. Fine. After calculating VP of K for PV bus, go to step number 10. Okay. So let us see what is there for step number 9, then we'll go to step number 10. Okay. So for the load bus kth iteration of load bus P, okay, VP of K can be calculated as, this is for all your load buses, PQ buses, you are going to use the Gauss-Seidel equation, VP of K, which all of you know. And after that, what do you do it? You find out the change in the last two iteration, which we call it as delta V max. Okay, delta V for that particular bus in that particular iteration. So I'm going to find out the change in the voltage for that particular pth bus in the, that is nothing but difference between your last two iteration of the same bus, okay? And after that, advance the bus count. You remember that we have said, if it is a slack bus, then go to step number 11. And I told you the step number 11 will be the increment of bus count. So you can check that over here. That is, advance the bus count by one and check if all the buses have been taken into account. If yes, go to step next step. Otherwise, go to step number 5. Fine. So step number 5 is again where you increase the iteration count. Okay. So now, sorry, you do the bus count. Fine. So here what happens? Find out the largest of the, now you're going to find out the delta V max. Fine. So there you will be finding out the delta V max. If this lies, then the tolerance go to. So you know you are finding out the delta V for every iteration for all the buses. Fine. So then every iteration you are going to check the delta V max. So if it is not less than or equal to the tolerance, then only we go for the increment of the iteration. You go for the next iteration. So you keep doing this process till you reach to the convergence, okay? So that is what all about step number 12. So that's what it says. You go to step number 4 if the delta V max is not less than or equal to the tolerance. Step number 13, display the calculated values of all node voltages. Fine, now your convergence, if your convergence has reached, then you need to calculate all the load node voltages, final node voltages you need to display, and then calculate the slack bus power after the voltages have converged. So this calculation of slack bus power, I have explained to you in lecture 9. So by using the same formula, you are going to find out the slack bus power, line flows, line powers, all those things, fine? So this is anyhow complex power for a slack bus is written. You can use the same formula and you can compute the line flows and line losses, fine? So which we have already discussed earlier. Okay, next, I hope the algorithm, including the PV buses, are also clear to all of you. Fine, so based on this particular concept, let us take one problem and understand what is it. So problem number one, what does the problem number one says? Obtain the load flow solution at the end of the first iteration of the power system shown in figure using Gauss-Seidel method. The data is given in the table. The solution table we'll see in the next slide. The solution is to be obtained for the following cases. So what are these cases? The case number one. Case number one says, bus 2 is a PV bus whose voltage magnitude is specified as 1.04. Okay, that is my first case. That is the voltage magnitude at this particular bus is given as 1.04. And case number two, we have varied the, if the Q limits are varied, 0.25 to Q2 is becomes a 1 per unit. Fine, so we have variation in the Q limits. Fine, previous the Q limits is different. I think it will be in the table. Fine, so we'll see what is the Q limits over there. Fine, so here, I think Q limits are not mentioned. I think previous case Q limits has to be, okay, let me go back. I think here Q limits has to be 0.1 to Q2 to 1. So for this particular case, let me say, I'll just take a pen and write down over here. That particular data is missing. For this particular case, we'll take the Q limits as, okay, we'll take the Q limits as 0.1 less than equal to Q2, okay, less than equal to 1 per unit, okay. So I'll just take the rubber and eraser and write down once again. I'm writing down since in there it is missing. So it'll be, I think so, it is 0.1 or 0.01. Let us check out what are the values. And then, because I've taken two cases, I've taken two cases where the Q limit is within the specified value, and the second case where the Q limit violates the values. Okay, limits it, the Q value, the calculated Q value violates the limit. So I, with the two cases, I wanted to explain you the concept. So let us see whether this limit is correct or not, and we'll check whether it is okay. So this is you basically is your, fine, this is your line data. And this is your bus data. So line data will help you to draw the network, as well as you can form the Y bus with the help of your line data. Bus data, we have discussed this particular problem in our previous lecture also. So I told you if the power, real and reactive power is given in form of injected, then whatever the values are there, you need to take it as it is. Fine. So in this particular case, the bus 2 will be taken as a PV bus. So basically we are taking the bus 2 as a PV bus, okay, whereas the other two is going to be PQ bus, and this is also PQ bus, and this is your slack bus as per the data. So in our previous lecture, we have taken all the three as a PQ bus. In this case, we are taking the bus two as a PV bus and three and four as a PQ bus, and we'll continue this problem. So whenever there's a PV bus, there is a concept of Q limits, fine. So the Q limits, we'll check whatever we have considered is right or not, because the first case I wanted to show whether when the Q calculated is within the specified limit. Fine, so let us see. So bus 2 is a PV bus and whose voltage magnitude is given 1.04. So we first compute the Q2 value because it is a PV bus. Bus 2 is a PV bus. So underline this. Bus 2 is a PV bus. So if it is a PV bus, the very first thing is you need to calculate the Q2, keeping in mind the V2 specified is 1.04, whatever is given in your problem. Fine, so this is the formula for Q2. When you open the bracket, you can use this way of, when you open the sigma sign, you can use this way also. And I get a value of 0.2082 per unit. So that means whatever the limits I have considered, it is right. I have taken the limit in the first case as 0.1 to less than equal to Q2 less than equal to is your 1 per unit. Fine. So your limit was what we have written is, I just write down once again. In the first case, please make a note over there and do the correction. Fine. So here it is 0.1 less than equal to Q2 less than equal to 1. Okay, less than equal to 1 per unit. Okay, so now when your answer is over here, 0.208, 0.208 is very much within the limits. Okay, so 0.20 is very much within the limits. So this is basically represents your Q mean and this is your Q max. This is your Q max and this is your Q min. So my calculated value, this is my Q2 cal. It is very much within the limits and hence this bus will be treated as a PV bus. Fine. So if it is a PV bus, what do? I calculate the V2 of 1 for the delta value. So basically I'll be calculating the V2 of 1 for a delta value. So you see that's V2 of 1. This is basically a V2 of temporary. So I will just write over here T. Okay, so I will write over here V2 1 of T. So this will give you V2 of 1 temporary. So in this temporary, I got this is the answer. I got this is as an answer in which I don't require the magnitude because it has been treated, our Q value is within the limit and the bus is going to be treated as a PV bus, which means the magnitude of the voltage at this particular bus is going to remain as the specified voltage, and specified voltage is nothing but 1.04. So I don't require this magnitude. What I require is the angle. Fine. So in this case, the voltage at this particular bus is going to be this 1.04 at an angle of 1.846 degree. So you can see it. So finally, the V2 of 1 is equal to 1.04, 1.846. Okay. Please keep it in mind. Do this. Don't write V2 of 1. Please make a note of V2 of 1 temporary. You write the temporary word, which will you will not have that confusion whether I take the temporary itself means that you require only the delta value. You don't require the magnitude value. Okay. So fine. So let us V2 of 1 is clear. And next, my other two buses are PQ buses. So I will be using the same Gauss-Seidel equations and will find out my V3 of 1. So V3 of 1 will give me the value of, it has given me 1.03 at an angle of minus 4.951. And V4 of 1 has given me the value of 0.99 minus 0.178 degree per unit. So I told in the previous classes also, please remember the answer should be near to your initial assumptions, which is nothing but 1 plus of J0. So your magnitude should be near to your value of 1 per unit. Fine. So this is the first case where we found that the value of Q is within the satisfying the limits. Fine. So we'll take case 2. So case 2, we have changed the limit from 0.25, the lower limit I have varied. Fine. So if you varied the lower limit, obviously, if you remember, we have got the calculated Q2 value as 0.208, and 0.208 is less than your 0.25. Okay, so which means it violates the lower limit. So which that means for this particular bus, the value of Q2 is going to be 0.25. You no more you will be taking this value. This value no more will be considered once it has violated the limit. Fine. So whichever limit it has violated, that particular value is going to be set. So Q2 is going to be equal to 0.25, which is your lower limit. Fine. So by using that, so iterations are carried out with this value of Q2, the voltage magnitude at bus 2 can no longer be. So you know that's the very first thing, that if it has violated the limit, so the very first thing, since it has violated the limit, it is going to be treated as, now it is going to be treated as PQ bus. So how do you treat the other PQ buses? Same way you are going to treat this bus also as a PQ bus, which means my voltage at this particular bus, initial voltage at this particular bus is going to be 1 plus of J0. So no concept of specified voltage will come into picture. Fine. So what I do it, I will use the V2 also as 1 plus J0. So your all the three buses is going to be PQ buses. And for first iteration, so these are after solving in the same Gauss-Seidel formula, you get these answers. Okay, so I request all of you, please do the problem and check these answers. In this subject, more you solve the problems, more your doubts will get cleared. Fine? Okay, quiz time. Okay, let us ask a few questions, whatever we have understood so far. Let us know that whether it is clear or not. Fine, so question number one, when the generator bus is treated as a load bus? Okay, in other word, when the PV bus will be treated as a PQ bus? So just now we have read, what is the answer, guys? Yes, correct. It will be treated as a PQ bus when it violates the Q limits. Okay, so if the reactive power of the generator bus violates the specified limits, then the generator bus is treated as a load bus. Okay, so this simple logic, I hope it is clear for everyone. Fine, let us go. The question number two, what will be the reactive power and bus voltage when the generator bus is treated as a load bus? Yes, what will be the reactive power and bus voltage when the generator bus is treated as a load bus? So what will be the reactive power? Reactive power depends on which limit it has violated. So if it has violated the lower limit, it will set to the Q minimum, or if it has violated the upper limit, it will set to the Q max, and that particular bus voltage will be calculated with the help of Gauss-Seidel formula. Fine, so that is what is the answer is all about. Okay, I hope this is clear. I repeat, the reactive power will be based on which limit it has violated. It will set to that particular limit, whether it is a minimum or maximum. And the bus voltage will be taken as your flat voltage profile. Initial value will become a flat voltage profile. And how you calculate for the PQ buses, the Gauss-Seidel formula Vp of K, same way you will be solving for this particular bus also. Hope I'm clear with this simple concept. So don't go wrong while calculating. So question number three, what will be the bus voltage when the generator bus is treated as a PV bus itself? Okay, if you found that your Q limit has not violated and this particular bus will be treated as a load bus, be treated as a generator bus, then what will be the voltage at that particular bus is going to be? Fine, so what it is that we are going to calculate, the magnitude of the voltage will remain as Vp specified, and delta of temporary we need to calculate. So which we have seen as, so we are going to calculate Vpk of temporary, and we are going to set that particular voltage as the specified magnitude and the delta temporary, which we are getting from this particular equation. Okay, so I hope with this concept, your load flow problem using GS method, including both PV and PQ buses, are clear to all of you. Okay, so thank you for listening. Next lecture, we will learn about a new topic, which is acceleration factor, which means how do you make your iterations faster and reaching to a faster convergence. Fine, so we'll see that in our next lecture. Thank you for listening once again, and bye, have a nice day.